Most people are afraid of bees, but these insects are actually very beneficial to our environment. Recently, Jenny Bach, a local beekeeper, came to campus to teach the Punahou community about the importance of bees in Hawaii. Here's a look at how she spread the word.
Well, the Honeybee Project specifically came out of a professional development that I had last spring with Malia Chong and Lori Ching, who are two sixth grade teachers with whom I went to Big Island to study some of the garden programs that they had going over on Hawaii Island. And as part of that trip, we actually met Jenny Bach, who's a Hawaii Island bee educator. So when Jenny came, she spent Thursday and Friday teaching all of the first graders basically about the bee, about the beehive, and then about how the bees make honey. So during that lesson, she basically introduced them to all the parts of the hive. We took apart a hive and showed them, you know, what different parts of the comb would look like, where the eggs are being laid and where the brood is being developed and then where the honey is being stored and stuff like that. And then we actually had an observation hive with the first graders as well, so they could look at the bees at work and look at the sort of what they're doing on the honeycomb and try and find where the drones are versus the worker bees. We didn't have a queen on that hive, but they're actually trying to just identify the different kinds of bees. And then I was working with them on doing some honey tastings where the kids would taste honey that was from different nectar sources, so like a kiawi honey versus honey that came from the eucalyptus tree, so they could see how the nectar really influenced the taste of the honey. And then basically the kids just got the chance to talk story with Jenny and ask questions about bees and talk about how they're scared of bees or scared of getting stung. And you know, Jenny likes to begin with where they are, but then just try and let them grow a little bit and teach them a little bit more so that they don't just see bees as these sort of like horrible insects that hurt you, but really these kind of fascinating creatures that are a real vital part of our ecosystem. And then after that, we prepped for the night, which was the movie night. So that began, guests were invited to come about 5:30, but we started getting set up around 4:30. At 5:30, we had a sort of open patio talk story time where we had farmers there who actually were honeybee, you know, raised honeybees and collected their honey. So those farmers, Dakota Miller, who's an eighth grader here, as well as Charlie Rapoon, who's an alumni, and then Michael Klitz, who's the president of the Hawaii Beekeepers Association, all had sort of booths set up so that people could just begin to, you know, learn a little bit of something about bees, about the role of bees in Hawaii, the different kinds of honey that comes from them. And then Scott Nikaido and the UH Honeybee Project folks were also there to show some of the issues that are facing honeybees today, like the varroa mite, like the hive beetle, things like that, and just what they look like, as well as, you know, different kinds of bees are in our environment. So like the carpenter bee and what is its role in our ecosystem, the leaf cutter bee, why we want to attract those kinds of things into our houses and homes and our spaces, because really they have specific roles to play as well. So after the movie, that started about 6, and we went, you know, screened the whole movie. Then we had our panel discussion where each of our panelists, they all got to share their perspectives and sort of how they look at honey and the importance of honeybees in our island ecosystem. So after that night, we actually had some of the morning off, and then right around lunchtime, we went back up to the first grade, did the last two classes that afternoon, same lessons as the day before. And then right after school was a educator lecture. So it was basically like, what would you need to know as a teacher who is interested in exploring how honeybees could become part of your curriculum? And the thing that I really loved about the workshop is that we had such a diversity of people. We had students, current students at Punahou. We had a first grader there who had been, you know, working with Jenny the day before and ended up bringing his mom, who's a science teacher up here in the academy. We had community members. A couple people had just randomly heard about it, you know, through word of mouth, and they ended up coming. We had a few alumni, a bunch of teachers, you know, and it was just such a nice mix, and everyone was really excited about, you know, trying to keep going with this. So one of the things we're thinking about doing now is actually forming, I don't know, like a bee hui, where people who are interested in actually trying to keep taking steps forward could meet maybe once a month and just start educating ourselves about it.
My reason for spreading the word for beekeeping is to really just educate people about the importance of honeybees and to bring that fear into an awareness and really change that idea of like honeybees are something that stings, rather into honeybees are important for us to survive and our food system to survive. I would tell someone that's interested in beekeeping that you just need to find your mentors and really see what is out there for your resources. And just try to get in touch with as many beekeepers as you can. Take a beekeeping course, which is the best way to start, and really get in with the bees with a mentor so you know what you're doing and what you're getting into.
Seeing so many people in our community coming onto the campus, such an energy of all these people really interested in talking about what they know and asking questions, and there was just such excitement about it. And you know, Food for Thought is about, you know, issues of sustainability, and I think we always think of sustainability as being something that's a problem that we have to like fix and we have to change what we're doing. And this movie felt more like, here's an opportunity to like almost like adopt a pet, you know, that you're gonna have these bees and bees are so neat and they give you this honey. And you know, Jenny really talks about becoming a bee guardian rather than a beekeeper, and really seeing the partnership with something like that, that I think a lot of people responded to that. So just that kind of energy that people brought to both the workshop and the movie night, it was really wonderful. Just seeing the community all come together over a common topic and really seeing people get excited about pursuing it together.